knows a lot about all kinds of stuff. Professor Dave Explains.
Earlier in this mathematics playlist, we developed a strong background in algebra and calculus. It's now time to put these to use in a fresh new topic. Differential equations are an incredibly useful tool with applications all over higher math, science, engineering, and beyond. They are the equations that describe our natural world. In fact, you can't throw a rock without hitting a differential equation, quite literally, because the gravity that curves the path of the rock can be modeled by them. Differential equations are used whenever there is a need to precisely describe something that changes. If you deposit money into a bank, it will accumulate interest at some rate, meaning that the rate of change of your bank balance is always proportional to the current balance, which will lead to a steady exponential growth in your assets. But if the world was that simple, everyone would be rich. In reality, external influences like economic inflation and variable interest rates due to monetary policy will complicate things. And yet, it can still be modeled just fine with a differential equation, and calculations like this are done by economists all the time. But the idea of modeling things that change over time and space is something that can be applied to pretty much anything, and that's exactly why differential equations are absolutely ubiquitous across any field of applied math. Let's take a look at some now. In demography, which is the study of human populations, the Verhulst equation describes how competition for resources places an upper limit on the number of people who can be safely sustained within a civilization. This equation was developed in the 1800s, back when scholars were having a vicious debate about whether the explosive population growth during the Industrial Revolution would lead to a catastrophic collapse of society, which was the prevailing Malthusian economic view of the time, rather than a smooth stabilization of the population. With the benefit of hindsight, we can see that neither of these ideas were quite right, although the concept of a carrying capacity is still relevant today, and analysts use sophisticated differential equations rooted on the same fundamental principles to predict what might happen to us in the future. In a similar vein, the SIR model can model the effect of viral infections throughout a large population as people become ill, recovered, or vaccinated, and it's rather self-explanatory how these kinds of calculations are very important. The navier-stokes equation describes the motion of flowing fluids, like the meandering of water in a river or the streamlined air flows that lift a fighter jet in flight. There is a $1 million prize up for grabs for anyone who can prove whether or not this equation always has a physical solution. In biology, the lotka-volterra equations model the populations of predating species of animals, and it predicts the seasonal cycles that really happen in nature, helping ecologists in targeted conservation efforts. You might have heard of some of the equations used in modern physics to describe every aspect of the universe, from electrodynamics with Maxwell's equations, to quantum mechanics with the Schrödinger equation, to general relativity with Einstein's field equations, which are differential equations that capture our understanding of reality in its purest form. And there are many, many more, all representing our dynamic, ever-changing world. So, hopefully, I don't need to convince you that differential equations will be a topic that you'll need to learn about if you want to study anything that's even vaguely related to describing reality. To get the most out of this series, you'll need to have a firm grasp of the entirety of the mathematics playlist up to this point, including all of trigonometry, calculus, and linear algebra. The study of differential equations can get quite intensive, but I'm here to guide you through this fascinating field of mathematics. So if you're confident you've got all your mathematical bases covered, let's begin our study of differential equations.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com. Thank you.